Hey everyone, welcome back to Serena's Toy Room. So, back to our regularly scheduled content. I wanted to make a video talking about all the dolls and stuff that I've gotten since November when I did my goodbye video. If you guys follow me on Instagram at Serena's Spam Room, you would see like whenever I got new dolls from the thrift store or brand new dolls and stuff. But if you don't follow me on there, which you should, just gonna catch you guys up to speed now. So let's get into it. It's gonna be in order from oldest to newest. First, which was shortly after that video, I believe, I got Best Fashion Friends Barbie, Wizards of Oz Glinda.
Tap your heels together three times.
2000s Barbie, I'm not sure what her name is. And Style Barbie, one of the like more budget ones, not fully articulated, and she has bangs. The Hair Princess Barbie, I'm not sure of the precise name, but she is like a hairstyling doll. And then Mycene Coasterama Chelsea. I was going to originally take all the dolls out and show you what they look like now and stuff, but I couldn't be bothered. That's a lot of dolls and I don't feel like putting them away afterwards. If I had them out and about, then I will show you. I actually have Best Fashion Friends Barbie right here, and she's kind of holding up my massive pile of books at the moment. It was originally over there, but then like the books got so high I needed something to kind of like keep them up and stuff, so she's kind of there for now. Next is a Belle plushie, because I've been collecting Disney Princess Disney Store plushies. The 50th anniversary gold dress Barbie, who is so beautiful. Picture Day Draculaura, which I actually have here because it is February currently, and February is Draculaura's birth month. First Camera Action Viperine, and both of them were like pretty much brand new, maybe minus a few accessories, but pretty much new, which was exciting. 2008 Holiday Barbie, who is one of my favorite holiday Barbies. High School Musical Troy and Max Steel. Troy I kept because I like boy dolls, and Max Steel, I actually really like those Max Steel. They're not dolls, but more action figures, but they're kind of like dolls to me. I really like them, they're cute. I have a thing for boy dolls. The first dolls that I got that I didn't open and review on YouTube was on Black Friday. I got them 20% off at the mall and it's a Disney store. It's Frozen 2, Elsa and Anna, the singing dolls. And I really, really love them. I initially only wanted to get Anna because I love how her hair looks in the second movie. I love how it looks down and the doll is super pretty. But then, like, I listened to Into the Unknown and I knew I had to get the singing Elsa that sings Into the Unknown. And I'm glad I got the both of them at the end of the day. Like, you can't just have one sister without the other. They have to be together. And I love them. They're super cute.
Yes.
It was weird to not open and review them on YouTube, but I did like little Instagram unboxings and stuff where I didn't talk. If you guys follow me, you would know what I'm talking about. Next would be a Pocahontas plushie and a Ken doll in a purple suit. He came with a Mattel Cinderella, which I resold. And yeah, not much to say about them, but I really like that Ken. Next, I found a brand new inbox Hasbro Snow White. This is from the first wave, and I thought she was really cute. And she was only like $5 and probably had a discount as well. And with her, I found a Barbie tote, which I actually really needed, and it's right there. Of course, I attacked it with stickers, which I always do with all my things that have blank surfaces. And I found a I Can Be Movie Star Barbie, High School Musical Gabriella, which I assume came with Troy. I assume they come the same owner, but put out separate times. Mattel, Ariel, and Tiana. And I was really excited to find this bag, mostly for Ariel, of course, but she's a really nostalgic doll. I had her back in 2011. Like, my sister, whenever I would go to school, she was like a toddler at the time, she would go in my room and like steal that Ariel doll in particular and like play with it, and over time it got so roughed up I just gave it to her and I was like so upset. Ever since I like never could find another new one, but I found her and I was so happy. She doesn't have her choker shoes or tiara, but it's still good to have her nonetheless. She's beautiful and Tiana's gorgeous as well. Liv Sophie, the one that came with a dog. I Can Be Bride Barbie, Singing Rapunzel. The Singing Rapunzel was actually a surprise. I didn't know she could sing until I undressed her to get her ready for wash and stuff. She's actually right here. She sings When Will My Life Begin? But she came in her little wedding dress. She's really pretty. Next would be the dolls and stuff I got for Christmas. So I got 2019 Holiday Barbie, which is awesome. The Aurora Bedroom Playset that came with this doll in a blue dress. It came with the bed and vanity and little accessories and the fairies. It's so cute. That was actually, my grandma bought it for me on Black Friday when I got Elsa and Anna, and she told me to put it away until Christmas, and I did so. And yeah, that was really nice of her. I really liked it. It was on sale at the time. Friday the 13th, part 6, Jason from NECA, which I have with my Freddy and Michaels. Hasbro Pocahontas from my grandmother. Fashionistas number 138, National Geographic Barbie, Fashionistas 107, My Little Pony, Magic of Every Pony set, came with several little blind bag sized ponies, Toonie Terrors, Chucky and Tiffany, Fashionistas 131, Fashionistas 119, Rainbow Sparkle Hair Barbie. So I'd say that was a pretty successful haul. That was probably the best haul I've had since 2015, and it's actually my favorite haul that I've had, like, ever, actually. Another thrift haul includes Garden Party Barbie, 92 Fashion Play Barbie, Hawaiian Fun Skipper, who is unfortunately, like, has a chewed up hand, like she's missing a hand, which is so sad, but I couldn't bring myself to throw her out because her face is really pretty and her hair is so pretty, so I'm just gonna keep her as is until I find a suitable body for her. So unfortunate though, I didn't know that initially when I bought her, obviously. First edition Liv Sophie, Rocker's Dare, Scarus Rochelle, 13 Wishes Twyla. And at the time I also found the Monster High school playset, the original one, and I was so happy. There was so many Monster High stuff there that day, that was great. If you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen that I take several pictures in that set, and it's so adorable. Christmas money, I got Friday the 13th Part 4 Jason, because that's my favorite Friday the 13th movie. So I like him better than the Part 6 one, but don't tell him that. Next is the beginning of an obsession for a new doll line. That's LOL Surprise, OMG, Lady Diva. She was so amazing. I was obsessed with her for days, and I had her out. I took, like, pictures of her and stuff. She is amazing. And it started an obsession, and I've gotten several since. And I actually got two in the mail today. So I'm going to be opening and reviewing those next. Another thrift haul would be Princess Charm School Blair. This is Barbie in a really cute tennis outfit, Locket Surprise Kayla, a Disney Store Ariel over here. And she's wearing an Ariel wedding dress that another doll in that thrift haul was wearing. And Megara, which I was so excited about. She was really, really roughed up, but I fixed her up and I made her look fairly presentable, I'd say. That was probably one of the best finds I've ever found at the thrift store, period. Another thrift haul would be Jamin and Jamaica Noli, who had sadly cut hair, but not as bad as another doll in that haul we'll get to in a moment. Juicy Bling Kennedy, Sweet 1600 Jackie Laura, who is right here, as you've seen. She's really cute. I wish she had her tiara though, but it's still fine. Infuriating Toralai, Fashionistas Wave 1 Cutie, Barbie with a really pretty neutral lip color. I really like her, that's why I've kept her. I really like the color of her lipstick and stuff. Then Fashionistas Hottie, who I have brand new, but I kept him anyways, even though it's a double because I really love Ken dolls, as you know. In this era of Ken, like the early 2010s, it's like my favorite era, probably. Masquerade Madness Noli, who is such an unfortunate soul. She had such cut hair that it was like no longer salvageable. It was like cut the scalp at the front and I couldn't save it. So I took all her hair out and I plan to reroot her very soon. I got her like probably like well over a month ago, but I still haven't gotten around to it, but I hope to soon, because the poor girl, I couldn't bring myself to just chuck her head away. She has such a pretty face, so I thought I would reroot her, even though I'd never done it before, but it's worth a try, I suppose. LOL Surprise Royal B. She is super pretty as well. She was my second LOL OMG doll. Ariel, Disney Store plushie. I have like three now. She's the third, but can never have too many Ariels, is what I always say. 1988 Holiday Barbie, which I also have. This one was like pretty much new, minus her shoes, and I couldn't resist. Pretty Hearts Barbie, who is so pretty. If I got her sooner, I would have added her to the February review station. 1989 Fun the Dress Barbie and Bath Blast Barbie. Next would be LOL Surprise OMG Candylicious. You guys know I had to have this one because I'm obsessed with pastel and pink and stuff. And she's like totally my essence and aesthetic captured in the two dolls. So she's like one of my favorite girls they've done so far. Freaky Fusion Nathan, which I was really excited about. He's missing a shoe, unfortunately, but I can live with that. Salon Surprise Barbie, Princess Ballerina Barbie, Super Gymnast Teresa, Musical Snow White and Friends Snow White, Wet n Wild Barbie and Flight Time Ken. And with them I also found a Barbie fashion designer set that came with outfits my grandma offered to buy it for me. She actually found it, not me, so if she wasn't there, I wouldn't have found it. And it's made several cute outfits for my thrifted dolls, which I'm excited about. And I also found a Daphne figure from Scooby-Doo. And I was really excited to find her because I had that exact Daphne figure growing up. They came in like a set, all the Mystery Inc. characters from Scooby-Doo. But of course, Daphne was my favorite. I love girly characters from shows and cartoons and stuff. Always have and always will. And I like played with her and she was like so roughed up. And over time, all the figures kind of just disappeared. But I'm so glad to have her again. She's like on my pink shelf and stuff. I got these two as a Valentine's present for myself. It's LOL Surprise OMG Busy BB and Alt Girl. I love them to death. I found Disney Star Maleficent at the thrift store. She came in a bag of another doll, which I'm reselling, but Maleficent was really cool, and I was so happy to find her because I love the villain dolls. And my most recent thrift haul, which is actually a couple of days ago, these three Barbies, I'm not 100% sure on their ID, so I'm kind of assuming their identification, like from personal experience with identifying Barbies. So the pink bodysuit girl, I'm assuming it's like one of the mix and match princess Barbies because those kind of came out around 2014, which is the face she has. I'm assuming the one in the middle, she has articulated knees, but not arms or anything else. So I'm assuming she was a pet or salon Barbie. And pet Barbies usually have bendable knees, so they're on their knees to treat the dogs or whatever. And salon Barbies usually have bendable knees to sit in the salon chair, so that was just my assumption. Budget Barbie from the early 2010s. She's just like one of those $5 dolls from back in the day, but she's super pretty. And then lastly, I found a Jeep Ken, like one of those Kens that come with Barbie in a little car. And I'm assuming so, I'm like 99.9% sure that's what he would be because he has two bent arms and they don't really do that for Ken these days. 2004 Holiday Barbie, who is so gorgeous. I love her face. She didn't have her original outfit, but she has one of those faces where it's like, I don't mind because I really wanted to dress her up in something really cute because anything would look good on her, honestly. Alright everyone, thank you for watching my little video today, and stay tuned for more to come from Serena's Toy Room. And until next time, Power Ray, subscribe, and see you in the next video. Bye guys!